Alright guys, so I just pulled in to St. Gregory's Abbey and home of the Maybe Garer Museum. This is where the scroll is taking me, so let's see what we find. This is very interesting. I don't know if there could be a mummy here. Let's find out. Okay guys, so I read the scroll that I found, and it said something about Shah and knees, and then this word right here, maybe you can see it, maybe, spelled very odd. So when I kind of thought about it and I put the clues together, it led me here to Shawnee and to the Maybe Garer Museum of Art. So not quite sure what I'm going to find, but I'm going to go ahead and head on in and see what's inside.
Guys, how crazy was it that we actually found a real mummy right here in Oklahoma? Remember, I read the scroll, and it was hard for me to figure out what it was trying to say. But it led me here to Shawnee, to the Maybe Garer Museum, and hard to believe that a mummy all the way from Egypt has made its way here to Oklahoma. And it's just a short trip down the road from Stillwater. Wow. You know, all this talk about mummies, though, has reminded me of a story from the Bible. When Jesus raised Lazarus from the dead, he came walking out of the tomb. He was all wrapped in the burial cloth. He couldn't look like a mummy. But this week, we're talking about how God is healer. So let's read this story from the Bible about how God healed Lazarus in the most amazing way, by raising him from the dead.
Stories of the Bible. Jesus raises Lazarus from the dead. This is Jesus.
Heyo!
Who is the Son of God and the Savior of the world. While Jesus was on earth, he taught everyone about God's love. He did many miracles and healed people of their sickness. Jesus had a friend named Lazarus who was very sick. He had two sisters named Mary.
That's okay.
And Martha.
Here you go.
Who sent a message to Jesus telling him, "Lord, your dear friend is very sick."
So come on.
But when Jesus heard about it, he said, "Lazarus's sickness will not end in death. No, it happened for the glory of God."
What?
So although Jesus loved Martha, Mary and Lazarus, he stayed where he was for the next 2 days.
All right, I don't know.
Finally, he said to his disciples, "Let's go back to Judea."
Are you sure?
But his disciples did not think this was a good idea because the people in Judea had tried to kill Jesus. But Jesus told them they were going anyway. He said, "Our friend Lazarus has fallen asleep, but now I will go and wake him up."
He'll be okay.
The disciples thought Jesus meant Lazarus was simply sleeping. So Jesus told them plainly, "Lazarus is dead."
What?
"And for your sakes, I'm glad I wasn't there. For now you will really believe. Come, let's go see him." Thomas said to his fellow disciples, Let's go too and die with Jesus. When Jesus arrived at Bethany, he was told that Lazarus had already been in his grave for 4 days. Many people had come to be with Mary and Martha because their brother had died. When Martha got word that Jesus was coming, she went to meet him. Martha said to Jesus, "Lord, if only you had been here, my brother would not have died. But even now I know that God will give you whatever you ask." Jesus told her, "Your brother will rise again." "Yes," Martha said, "he will rise when everyone else rises at the last day." Jesus told her, "I am the resurrection and the life. Anyone who believes in me will live even after dying. Do you believe this, Martha?" "Yes, Lord," she told him. "I have always believed you are the Messiah, the Son of God." Then she returned to Mary. She told Mary, "The teacher is here and wants to see you." So Mary immediately went to him. When the people who were at the house consoling Mary saw her leave so hastily, they assumed she was going to Lazarus's grave to weep.
"Oh, let's go too."
So they followed her there. When Mary arrived and saw Jesus, she said, "Lord, if only you had been here, my brother would not have died." When Jesus saw her weeping and saw the other people wailing with her, a deep anger welled up within him. "Where have you put him?" he asked them. They told him, "Lord, come and see." Then Jesus wept. The people who were standing nearby said, "See how much he loved him?" But some said, "This man healed a blind man. Couldn't he have kept Lazarus from dying?" Jesus was still angry, and he arrived at the tomb. "Roll the stone aside," Jesus told them.
"Wait, hold on, Jesus."
But Martha protested, "Lord, he has been dead for 4 days. The smell will be terrible." Jesus said, "Didn't I tell you that you would see God's glory if you believe?"
"Go ahead."
So they rolled the stone aside. Then Jesus said, "Father, thank you for hearing me. You always hear me, but I said it out loud for the sake of all these people standing here, so they will believe you sent me." Then Jesus shouted, "Lazarus, come out!" And Lazarus came out, his hands, feet, and head wrapped in cloth.
Hello?
Jesus told them, "Unwrap him and let him go."
Wahoo!
Many of the Jews who were there believed in Jesus, for he had raised Lazarus from the dead.
So guys, that was how God raised Lazarus from the dead. So this week we're talking about how God is my healer. God is my healer and is your healer. That's amazing. And so we can ask God for help with anything. God wants to heal you. Body, soul, mind. Any problem that we have, God wants to be there for us. All we have to do is ask. Even if it's something as great as what he did with Lazarus. And so don't be afraid to ask God for anything. Even a healing. Because God wants to give you good gifts. Alright, so that's all we got for this week. Thank you guys so much for watching our first episode of Xavier Kids at Home for this year. I'm excited for all of the episodes to come. We've got way more planned. And remember, if you forget everything, here is your need to know. That God is my healer. Say it one more time. God is my healer. Now, one last thing we've got to do. We've got to give God praise. They say when you sing, you pray twice. So let's all sing together.
My father.